What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today's content is a little different. So I bought a new rig, and in typical DSM YouTube channel fashion, it's an off-road rig. So this thing's actually a little cooler. It's a 93 Hilux Surf, so it's a Japan 4Runner basically. So it's right-hand drive. It is an auto. It still looks super dirty, but I actually cleaned the crap out of it already. The back seat's a freaking couch back here. The whole rear is pretty open. It's got subs in it. It's got a tailgate pretty much. I'd have to roll down the window, but this opens, the window rolls down, that rolls out like a tailgate. It's slightly lifted. I think it just has like a 1-inch lift or 2 inches maybe. It's on 32 1150s and it's a turbo diesel. So pretty much got this thing for a steal. I was like, man, if it runs and drives, I'll give you money for it. And I'm actually a little late to this intro because it already gets dark around here at like 6 o'clock. And it's finally the weekend. First weekend since I've had it. I've already put like $1,000 into it, into maintenance and everything. And yeah, so here's a nice little Turbski. I already deleted the AC because it was like halfway deleted and cleaned up all the pipe. It's got some ghetto things, threw in a new filter for the time. The snorkel is legit and it does come up through the fender well. I just have to drill a hole and actually plumb it to make it all good. But this thing's freaking sweet, dude. And it had like, so maintenance wise that I already did, which I technically recorded previously to this. So this video is probably going to be very poorly put together, but I did front brakes on it, so it's got all brand new front brakes, repacked the front wheel bearings, and it had a pretty gnarly vibration. I managed to find a drive shaft in town, which I just put on, and the exhaust, actually I think it's over here under all the rest of this crap, but yeah, it's right here. So the exhaust was all like cracked and blown out and bouncing. This piece was just like not even connected and it was chilling on the subframe, so I pretty much just lopped off the downpipe where I could. I bought this little exhaust tip for the Miata and never put it on, so I slapped it on here. It happened to fit like perfect, so right now it's just all dumped out, but it's a little rough around the edges. I'm cleaning it up. I've already done a crazy amount of stuff to it from where it was to where it is now. It's technically actually drivable. It wasn't very drivable on the highway. The whole drive shaft actually had a bend. It like rotated like that. So I'm about to take it out the road and go crawl around a little bit and see how she does. This thing is way too cool for what it is, dude. Right-hand drive, if you guys have never driven it, it's not horrible, not too hard to get a hold of. She's still a little hoppy, but I pretty much swapped out all the fluids on everything and tightened up a bunch of stuff, but it's awesome. It actually has a sound system too, which I'm not gonna play music to get copyrighted or nothing. It's not like it's fast or anything. I think it makes like 80 horsepower and like a buck 20, buck 30 for torque. So, but it sounds cool. Diesel things. Super stoked on it. Right, let's see how nasty this oil is. I think the person before me has a fail. Forgot to grab my ratchet. The person before me didn't even put a crush washer on, I don't think. So it's like slowly dripping out of here. The threads feel a little rough. It doesn't look horrible, just looks dirty as fuck. Alright, so I changed the oil and we added some diesel additive. Now I did the other gallon into it. This motor only takes like 7 quarts, so I'm just filling up with that. And then I pulled the rear drive shaft because it has kind of a big vibration on it, so I'm gonna see if I can drive it without it and if it still vibrates. I'm doing a horrible job at filming this. I need to get a cameraman, but what we're doing now is just pulling out some AC stuff. Whoever did whatever first, there was no condenser in it. So I'm just deleting the lines, which is clearing this all up. I got so much gunk out of these intake pipes. Like, they were, this thing especially was insane. This filter is all messed up. So I'll probably get a new filter and stuff tomorrow, but cleaned out the intake of the turbo. This thing is itty bitty. I'm actually gonna pull the compressor too to open all this up, kind of just open things up, but I'm slowly getting there. I pulled the drive shaft out and it actually wasn't, the U-joint really didn't have very much play in it at all. So I think that's actually good. I think the drive shaft itself might be bad, or something in the rear end might be bad. So I pretty much just re-greased all the joints in the yoke and it kind of tidied it up some. So once I finish pulling some more stuff, I'm gonna go test drive it and see if it still vibrates like it did. And if it does, I'll probably end up either finding a different rear end or a new drive shaft. I don't know yet, we'll see. It's all packing down. I did this brake already. I still gotta do this brake. So tonight I'm probably gonna finish cleaning all this up, get this brake pulled out, clean up all the grease and stuff for the wheel bearing and repack all that. And then yeah, hopefully if somehow that vibration got taken care of, then I want to take it out the road this weekend and go have a little bit of fun in it. Maybe get some content. Maybe I can get a thumbnail for this. I don't know, post up on a rock, but we'll see. So yeah, I'm just going to keep deleting stuff and clean it up, and I'll see you when I see you. First drive through, right hand drive, coffee shop. Got Dakota making up some spritzers for us, but looks like the rain's coming, but we're going that way away from the rain, so. So I get overdrive to work on this thing. It's cruising about 60 miles per hour, about 2800 RPM. There's a big hole. There's no rear sway bar on this thing right now, so it's definitely a little body rolly, and some of these turns are a little big, so I'm not pushing it much more than this, but it's cruising nice. All right, so this video, much like the rest of mine, totally not constructed like in a good way. But anyways, I think I said last time in the video, four-wheel drive wasn't working. Well, we ghetto rigged it. So I am heading out the road with this thing. We technically only got four low, but I guess that's all that we need. Got my hands full of everything. And I'm bringing the pups. So, got Talon, yes, big boy, and Mitsu, and they're gonna be riding with us today. So, sorry, unloading all my things. I'm sure that they're not gonna be fans of wheeling and bouncing over sticks and everything. They're gonna have a very difficult time staying in the seat, but we'll see how it goes. So, get some more footage when we head out the road. We made it out here to the end of the cove. It's a nice sunset. And this thing did great. I've been trying to rip it in two wheel as much as possible. Making it out here, I didn't really need four, but climbing through the trees and stuff's been pretty fun. So far I'm loving this thing. And I just got a bunch of stuff to show that just showed up in the mail. So I'm gonna have a couple more mods to do to it here soon, and then probably bring it back out for some more fun and try to get some more content. So peace out. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, and catch you next video.